Welcome back to New Today Cleveland. Guess what? It's that time of year again for the Progressive Cleveland Boat Show and Fishing Expo. That's right. And here to explain how you can enjoy this year's reimagined event is Michelle Burke. Michelle, I remember when you first took this show on, a big, giant job. You've done it a couple of years now, a wonderful job. And now you had to reinvent it. So how are we doing it?
Yeah, David, this year has been like a game of Jumanji where something new is coming at me all the time. So what we've done this year, you know, nothing is going to replace our in-person show, and we can hardly wait for that to come back. But what we did is we built a website and the ability to interact with our customers through text messaging the entire show or email. All of our dealers that are participating in the show have put boats into the show, and then they are going to have events in their dealerships, both online, where we have a full schedule of those on the site when the site launches on the 15th at 5, and also some smaller group events that you would make a reservation for. So it's very interactive. It's not just a virtual boat show. I call it a hybrid event where the customer's going to be able to explore so much on the site and then go into the actual dealerships to see the boats. You know, boating is touch and feel, so nothing's going to replace that.
So it's clevelandboatshow.com. Is that where people go?
Yeah, they're going to go there right now and register. When they register, they'll get a text message and an email from us. And with that, they can interact through the entire show with any questions they have. So on the weekends, we're going to do our own Cleveland Boat Show broadcast and be doing boat walkthroughs at participating dealers. So if someone's watching, they can go ahead and text a question. You know, hey, Michelle, what's under the seat there? And we'll be able to respond to them and answer all those questions.
Somebody's calling me today. I have to hang up on them. There we go. Forgot to silence my phone. What do you think of that, Michelle? Hey, so anyway, I think one of the interesting things about this, too, is you could do this 24 hours, right? You could go onto the site at night. So if you're thinking about it in the morning, you want to do something about it at night, you can still go check it out then.
Yeah. So what they've done is put boats in the show. So on the site, we'll have various categories, whether it's bow riders or center consoles or yachts. And so the customer can go on there, compare models, make, see which dealership they're at, and then make their game plan to go visit those dealers the next day.
So this is amazing. And the other part I think is interesting is you said it's still possible for people, if they're interested in buying a boat, they can bargain and barter with a couple different dealers at the same time.
Yeah, they probably don't want me to encourage that, but yes, they can.
But I just think that's great. So you get a virtual tour of one boat, and then how do you move yourself over to another location? How do you do that?
So what we're actually doing is when a customer actually clicks on the boat in our website, it's going to take them right to that dealer site for that boat. And then all of our dealers have their own text messaging, their own lead collection, their own area for those people to ask questions. And so they can work that way with them. And then, of course, like I said, when we're live at a dealership, they can ask questions live. With the actual dealers, they'll be able to say, hey, I'd like to do a FaceTime with you. Walk me through this boat. You know, people need to be careful, and we know that. And then they can make an appointment to go in even off hours so that they don't have to be around anybody else that might be in the showroom. You know, again, we're all being very cautious with COVID. The last thing we wanted to do was to cancel this event, though. It's a beloved event for so many, for 64 years. One of the things I've responded a lot on social media is, no, it's not the same. You know, people think, yeah, it's not the same. Yeah, no, it isn't the same. Nothing's the same right now for any of us. However, we can hardly wait to get back to the in-person shows. But for this year, we're able to give them something that still, yeah, has that flavor of boating. The other thing, David, that's important for people to know is, you know, inventory is very limited this year. The pandemic was the best thing to happen to the boating industry in decades. People bought boats like crazy last summer. Heading into this summer, manufacturers cannot keep up. So I always say that the boat show, there's no better time to buy a boat, and that holds so true for right now, because if you want that boat this summer, you're going to want to shop this January.
Yeah, I mean, it makes a whole lot of sense. You want to keep your family together. You want some social distancing. You need something to do. What a great adventure. Get a boat. And one of the things that really stands out to me is I remember last year we talked about this. I asked you, how much does it cost to get in? How much does it cost to park? So how much does it cost to get in this year? And how much does it cost to park?
It's all free.
Nothing, right? It's terrific. So congratulations on finding a way to keep the boat show together. Like you said, 64 years, it's one of the greatest boat shows in America, and you're keeping it going. Thank you very much.
David, thank you. I miss seeing you in person.
I miss seeing you, too. And I love the job you've been doing with the boat show. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.